Hi friends, my name is Nandita. I am from Andhra Pradesh.
Children, now let us discuss about viruses. Viruses are also microscopic. They are not considered as microorganisms because they behave like non-living organisms when outside the host and reproduce only when inside the host cell. You might know, children, microbes only for causing harm to human beings by causing diseases and making us ill. But the truth is, microbes are also beneficial to us in a variety of ways. They help in preparation of several household industrial products like curd, cake, bread, antibiotics, beverages, etc. They also help in the environment, acting as decomposers and biofertilizers. They play an important role in sewage treatment as well as. Viruses are smallest organisms and can be seen only under an electronic microscope. Let us discuss the characteristics of viruses. Children, viruses do not show any characteristic of living things. Viruses do not have an organized cell structure. Viruses do not respire, feed, grow, excrete, move on their own. Viruses can only reproduce if they enter in a living cell or other organism. When virus enters into any living cell, it starts behaving like a living thing by carrying out the process of reproduction. Outside the living cell, viruses behave as a non-living thing. Due to all these reasons, viruses are considered to be an intermediate form between the living and non-living thing. Children, now let us discuss the structure of virus. Viruses do not have an organization structure. Viruses are a cellular, that is, their body has no cellular substance or nucleus. Virus consists of a nuclear material coated with proteins. Viruses typically have one or two strands of DNA or RNA. The genetic material of viruses are covered with a protective coat of protein called capsid. Children, now let us discuss how do viruses grow and how viruses reproduce. Children, viruses cannot reproduce by themselves. Viruses attaches itself to a specific host cell, or the cell within it can reproduce. After attaching the host cell, virus infects the nuclear material inside the host cell. The nuclear material of virus attached to the nuclear material of the host cell. The nucleic material of virus take the custody of the manufacturing system of the cell. The host cell ignores its own need and switches to make new viruses. The host cell sometimes destroy in the process, and many of the new viruses are released to infect the other host cells. Children, now let us discuss the advantages of virus. Even though viruses has lost of disadvantages, but some viruses play a vital important role in ecosystem. For example, the bacteriophage, which are also called as bacterial virus, plays an important role in marine ecology and carbon cycle. Bacteriophages in the sewage has the ability to kill harmful bacteria and keep the bacterial level in control. Scientists are caring to find out viruses which can be used to kill bacteria and can be used instead of antibiotics. Now let us discuss the disadvantages of virus. Viruses have many disadvantages as they are the agent of many diseases. Virus causes diseases to many animals and plants. Human diseases such as common cold, influenza, measles, chickenpox, smallpox are all caused by virus. HIV or common immune deficiency virus causes AIDS in human beings and some animals.